Hello, this is Jake from the Corona team, and in the next few minutes, you'll be able to use Corona decals to easily add graphics, potholes, and surface imperfections to any object in your scene, all within the 3D viewport and without a UVW map in sight. So a decal allows us to project a material onto any object it's facing. We can create a decal using the decal button on the Corona toolbar, and just click and drag to create one. Apply a material to it and we can see that it's now projected onto everything within the decal's bounding box. We can move, rotate, and scale decals in the viewport and get them placed exactly where we want. We can adjust the size of our decal using the height and width parameters, or use the handy fit to bitmap function, and this will match the aspect ratio to a texture. Or use fit to assign material and it's going to match the aspect ratio to the texture on the assigned material. The depth limit is going to change the depth of the bounding box and in turn limit the depth of the projection. Under mask source, we can control the opacity. If we want to use a map that's independent from the material, we can select map and plug in a map from our material editor. So we can see that the checkerboard map is now dictating the opacity. If we use from material, the opacity is going to come from the material's opacity map. Now I'll unhide this car graphic and we can see that it's applied to everything within the bounding box. We can use the max angle limit to change at what angle the decal is applied. So currently at 180, we can see that it's applied to the back faces as well. And if we bring this down to 90, we can see that it's been removed from any back faces. So the max angle limit will change the direction of the decal's projection. There's also an option for max angle blur to ease the blending of the edge of the angle limit. So we can see that this edge is now less refined. So we might not want to have our decal applied to everything within the bounding box, and using the exclude button, we can exclude objects from receiving the decal. So an obvious part to exclude would be the ground. And if I turn on wireframe, we can see that I've broken this car mesh into two. And the purple represents the area which I want my decal and the green I do not. So we can use the exclude include dialog box to manage what to include or exclude from receiving the decal. In this case, we want to exclude the main car. And now the decal is not being projected onto the main car. As well as being able to move, scale and rotate decals, we can also duplicate them. We can stack up as many decals as we like. So if I unhide this side strip, and if I unhide this logo, we can see that appear on top. And if I unhide the tire marks and this white line, we can see that the white line actually appears above the tire marks. And we can easily change the order by changing the height. So now the tire marks appear on top. Displacement is also supported, making this a really powerful tool, meaning we can add depth to the cracks and potholes by just having a displacement map plugged into our material. Adding surface details and imperfections was considered going the extra mile, but decals in Corona make this process simple. And as you can see, we can get pretty creative with decals. I look forward to seeing what you come up with, and make sure you check out our other videos to continue exploring what Corona can do for you.